Mike and Daniel are fast approaching their first debt payment to Mark and Digger. With the deadline uncomfortably close, they've been trying to bootleg 5 gallons of premium whiskey at a premium price. But so far, they've had no luck.
Me and Daniel have been busting our chops day in and day out. We've got us a payment up. We got to go meet Mark and Digger and see if we can't get these boys paid up a little bit today. I've got a deadline. They want the payment, and they want it now. So we're going to get rid of this liquor. And I know it'll sell for a high price. I'm damn confident in our liquor, so I'm going to go and try to drive a hard bargain. That looks like our fella there, Daniel boy. How you doing, buddy? Take you a horn of it, see what you think.
Mm, smells good, don't it?
Mulberry rye we got.
Oh,
yeah, buddy, you can taste both of them in it.
Yeah, absolutely. That's good. That's really good.
Well, the...
How much you got?
We got 5 gallons.
5 gallons.
On the truck.
900 gallons?
There ain't no damn way I can do 90, brother. I was thinking more on the end of 160 a gallon.
I'll do 100 a gallon.
I don't know, buddy. You're going to have to do a lot down better than 100 bucks a gallon, because I'll be rightly honest with you. We got a lot of sweat, blood, and tears into this run right here. We got a lot of stuff that we got to get paid off, and that ain't none of nobody else's business, you know. But we've got a certain price we need, and we know it's worth it, and there's no way I can't go under 150. There's just no way. I don't know why in the hell we're having such a hard time selling this Mulberry rye. We want a high price for it, but I've never in my life had this much trouble trying to get any liquor sold.
Exactly, we'll do about 110. That's about as good as I can do.
We're $40 short, brother. I can't be running just slam behind on paying these boys, you know. I don't want them having to call me and say, hey, Mike, where's part of our money at? I've got to get this stuff sold. Damn it. It's good whiskey. Me and you feels like it's worth it.
Yeah, it's definitely good. You can taste Mulberry.
It's damn right.
On a back road in Sevier County, Tennessee, Shiners Mike and Daniel have a possible buyer lined up for their Mulberry rye.
We got one more chance to try to get this stuff sold before we gotta go meet Martin Digger. Where's this guy?
Late.
Look here. My buyer here, but. How you doing, man? I could tell when he got out of his car he was gonna drive a hard bargain with me.
You wanna try it?
Oh, yeah.
Like that?
That's real good.
It's good stuff, ain't it? We'd like to get about 160 a gallon for it.
Oh, I might be able to do 120.
Be honest with you, all I'm gonna be able to do is 140. If I can't sell it for that, I'll take it back home with me.
Yeah. I can do that.
140? I'll get you some liquor. We haggle back and forth. $140 a gallon. I took a little loss. But you know what? At this point, I'm glad to get rid of it. I just hope we've got enough that Mark and Digger will be satisfied with what I give them.
Well, we're on time, so they're late.
I don't care if he's a few minutes late, if he's bringing money.
Yonder they come.
There he is, but see what we got in store here, haven't we?
Man, yeah, let's get this shit over with.
Hello, girls.
What's going on, bud? Got y'all a payment here, whichever one of you want
to. I give it to him.
I don't want it, but I like it.
That's it. It's 1,800. That's a little over a quarter of what I owe you boys.
Man, couldn't you come up in the morning?
Well, we've been running liquor day in and day out. It's all there. I promise you, I wanted to hit y'all halfway, you know, this time, but I just couldn't make that happen.
It takes a lot of runs on the 30-gallon pot.
I'm telling you.
Well, we'd hope for some more.
I just hope you guys all understand. I mean, I do have a family to feed.
We
and,
do.
And that right there is reassurance that I'm trying. You know, I'm trying my hardest.
You know, you can't demand something from a man that he doesn't have. So I'm going to take his word for it. I think we're headed in the right direction, buddy.
Yeah, you know, I was always told, if a man's word ain't no good, he ain't no good.
It's all he's got is rattlesnake meat.
That's it.
They understand that I'm making the effort. But me and Daniel, we've got to start turning out a lot more liquor because we're basically killing ourselves.
What are we going to do to up our production? We've got to do something.
Yeah.
But I don't know.
Just past mid-season, and Mark and Digger have put their name to 348 gallons of shine. Josh's season has stalled out at 124 gallons. For all his work, Mike has got just 62. And Red Fox has kicked off his new partnership with 8 gallons of brandy.
What we gonna do to up our production? We got to do something.
In Sevier County, Tennessee, Mike and Daniel are trying to come up with a quicker way to dig themselves out of debt.
Me and Daniel, we've been bowed up, buttholes and elbows, trying to make this happen.
What about building 250-gallon pots?
You know, running two pots, you got twice the chances for leaks, twice the gas you got to burn. What about building a 100-gallon pot and put a divider in it?
Splitting one steel up?
Yep, right in the middle. Put a divider in.
As soon as we can get this debt paid off, that's more money me and Daniel can stick in our pocket. So we've got to do something different. What do you got in mind?
I'm thinking make one little short, fat 100-gallon pot.
Mm-hmm.
And put a divider in that joker. And then you'd have 50 gallon of mash here and 50 here. We could run a blueberry here and a rye here. We'll use our old burner. We'll have two different steams and vapors traveling into one cap, one arm.
I like the idea, but this thing, it's going to be hard to do, and it's got to be right. I mean, it's got to be soldered all the way around.
Built correctly, a split chamber still could potentially double their output while ensuring the flavor combinations of a high-dollar shine.
That'll help us, as opposed to running 5 to 7 gallons, we'll have
12 to 15 gallons
of liquor going off. And
that way we can get the debt to Mark and O'Tigger paid back.
Our season goal for this year is 800 gallons, and I don't see that happening unless we build this new pot.
Let's do this.
That's what we need to do. And let's keep it secret.
Heck yeah.
Let's go get some materials, Bubba. I don't see no reason we need to tell Martin Digger what we got. I don't think they need to know anything about it. It ain't none of their business what we're running on. We got mouths to feed and bread to put on the table, so we don't plan on telling them nothing.
Gotta work.
Make liquor, make money.